A memo recommending a ban on Philippine offshore gaming operations sent to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Finance Secretary Ralph Recto made that confirmation Tuesday, saying it's now up to the president to make a decision. Recto just this week said he had no objections against calls to ban POGOs, citing the controversies surrounding the industry. Credit card reporting firm TransUnion sees younger Filipinos driving the growth in credit card use in the country. The firm made that assessment, saying the number of Gen Z members who got credit cards more than doubled over the past 5 years. TransUnion expects the Philippine credit market to continue to grow as these Gen Z consumers, or those born between 1997 and 2012, reach adulthood. It notes credit card volumes jumped to 11 million in late 2023 from the 9.3 million the year before that. As for credit card spending, it was up 39% to a staggering 853 billion pesos in the first half of last year. Let's check on European markets. They're staging a rebound after 2 days of losses due to the political uncertainty triggered by the French election. Travel and leisure stocks are leading gains in the region. As for Wall Street, futures are pointing to a positive open as well, with the S&P 500 possibly extending its record rally. Investors will be tuning in again for the second day of Fed Chief Jerome Powell's congressional testimony. They're also bracing for Thursday's CPI report and Friday's producer prices.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Volkswagen after the company issued an overnight profit warning and announced it was considering the closure of its Audi plant in Brussels due to weak EV demand. Volkswagen shares dipped 1%. Also in focus, shares of Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing, which saw its second quarter sales grow as the AI boom continues. New York listed shares of the world's largest chipmaker rose 2% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Microsoft, which is reportedly relinquishing its observer seat on the OpenAI board amid increasing regulatory scrutiny. Microsoft shares are up 0.5% in pre-market trading.
Asian markets ended Wednesday trade on a mixed note as investors weighed Fed Chief Jerome Powell's testimony and China's inflation data. Japan's Nikkei 225 surged to another record high, boosted by financial and tech stocks. The Shanghai Composite, meanwhile, resumed its decline just a day after snapping a four-day losing streak. That's after consumer prices rose less than expected, while deflation persisted in producer prices. Here at home, the local bourse failed to extend a two-day rally, with the main index slumping 1%.
Today, I'm actually quite shocked that our market didn't do better, considering how well foreign markets did overnight. You know, my best explanation here is that our market has hit the 6,500 resistance level, and it struggled to break beyond that. We traded above it for a little bit, as you mentioned, but I think, ultimately the sellers won in the end. As far as what investors should do, I still think equities right now are incredibly cheap. I think it's a great time for investors to lock in some of these corporations that aren't just cheap, but are paying really high dividends.
Some notable stock movements in the region. Shares of TSMC climbed 0.5% after the chipmaker reported better than expected second quarter revenue growth. Meanwhile, fellow chipmaker Samsung saw a flat close. That's as its workers' union said it would extend what was supposed to be a three-day strike indefinitely.